What's the matter? You look a little worried this morning.
I am worried, George. And I should think you will be too. Do you realize what day is this?
It's Wednesday. What's the matter?
It's Bob's birthday. He's 16 today. And he's determined to quit school.
Quit school? Oh yes. I remember his vow of that. But he's not serious. Is he, Margaret?
Mean it? I'd say he does. Do you know what he just said to me? Off to school, little boy. I've got big things of mine. And me, 2 years older than he is.
Hey, mother. Doesn't Bobby go to school today? He says he never going anymore. And look at him. All dressed up in his new suit and his hair combined and everything.
Wow, Clark Gable in disguise. Hey, did you use my razor?
Stop it, children. Eat your breakfast. And now, what's all this about?
Nothing, Dad. I don't know what they're so excited about. I'm 16 now. I'm through the school and I'm going out to get a job.
A job? Who'd give you a job?
That's what I say. It's hard enough for men grown to find a work. Let alone a little baby not out of 9th grade.
George, I think it's your duty to speak to Bobby. Tell him to march right along to school. This is instant.
Now, Margaret. Be calm and let's look at this thing sensibly. I'm not going to command Bobby to do anything. We've talked this thing over before and I want him to make his own decision.
But George, he's so young, so foolish. He doesn't realize how important school is.
I realize how important it is, Mother. I just already feel like it, but I want to be a mechanic. It's what good school do to me.
That's what they all say. What are you going to do for the rest of your life? Check your brain in the parking lot?
School's too hard for him. That's trouble.
Hard? Don't make me laugh. What's so hard about it?
Everything. As far as you are concerned, didn't you have 4 red marks on your last report card? Why? It looked like forest fire.
Red marks? That's kid stuff. I can do the work if I wanted to. I'm just not interested in the day of the Civil War or how much the square root of 16 is.
Children, that's enough. Bobby, do you realize what you're doing?
Of course, Dad. I've told you all this before. They don't teach us what we want to learn in school. They teach us only what we don't want. Latin, civics, and algebra, and science. They never do me any good. I want to be a mechanic. I want to work with my hands. I want to make things interesting me. I want to start now, not waste the next 3 years of my life.
I know how you feel, Bobby. But it's my job to tell you you're making a big mistake. I'm older than you. I've seen how important education is to everyone. You may not need it now, but you need it later. No man knows too much, Bob. And there isn't a thing you learn that won't help you somehow, but someday.
Bobby, be a good boy and listen to what your father said. It's for your own good, son. It's for your own good.
I know, Mom. I'm listening and I'd do anything you ask me. But well, can you see how I feel?
Worry, son, if that's the way you want it. I'm not going to force you. We brought you all up to make your own decision after we've told you the facts. I wish you wouldn't do this. But it's your own choice, and I hope it will be a happy one.
Well, come on, Lord. We can get a ride to school with Dad. See you later, Bobby. Or should I say Mr. Thornton?
You'll be sorry someday for causing all this trouble, and it will serve you right.
Well, children, if you can lay aside your books for a moment, I'll show you something that all the homers in the world can buy you.
What is it? See for yourself. Just take a peek out the window.
Wow, a car? Boy, that's a handy. Is it really yours, Bobby?
Signed, sealed, and delivered. 75 bucks it cost me. That's what a job can do for you. Look at those lines and those oh to hear the motor. How many other kids 17 years old can point to a car like that around here?
I wouldn't want to point to it.
You wouldn't? Why yeah. not?
Look at that mud guard. Why it's half off?
Oh, that's nothing. I can fix it in 2 minutes.
But the color box? It's awful. And there's the crack in the windshield.
Say, what do you expect for 75 bucks for us, Lincoln Zephyr?
No, but I don't see anything. Anything that wonderful of that car. Is that all you have for your schoolwork? Then I'm glad I'm staying school.
I don't know, Ruth. It looks weird to me.
Now you're talking, Larry. These women, they never satisfy.
Really?
How do you say it?
I never be satisfied, Bobby, with the halfway of things. Imagine comparing a car, an old deal, Ken, with years of troubled education.
Here comes the lecture again. Well, don't expect me to listen. I'm going for a ride.
Seriously? Larry, you must wake up and down like that. It's hard enough to concentrate as it is.
Oh, concentrate. That's all I ever do. I'm tired of school and homework and books and all that goes there.
Why, Larry?
Well, I am. What fun do we have ever stopped here in the house? Every night of the week, look at Bobby. When the whistle blows at 5 o'clock, he's too finished. Not a single thing to do until the next day.
Larry, not you too. Don't tell me you want to quit school.
I don't know what I want to do. It seems to me that Bobby is doing all right. He has plenty of money in his pocket. A car to run around.
Plenty of money in his pocket? Larry, don't be foolish. He gets $14 a week. Less than 30 cents for an hour. Do you call that money? If he had to live on it, he'd starve to death, and how much will he need it? For a few years?
He'll be making more money then.
How? He has no education. He's stuck right away, and he is for the rest of his life.
Well, maybe you're right at that.
Of course I am right. I know how hard is Larry. But just think, in a few more months, we are both graduating. Then, well, be prepared, prepare for your work and advancement. Oh, here comes the trouble.
This is the life. No worries, no homework, no report card, no nothing.
You have to amuse yourself some other way, Bobby. We can study with all that noises going on.
Oh, study? Don't you ever think anything else? I'll tell you what I'll do. I'll take both of you down to the Paramount. Listen. Tyrone Power and Anita Lewis in the dark forest on the stage. Benny Goodman and his jitterbugs swingster. Wow! Let's go. Well, come on. What do you say? I've got plenty of money.
No, Bobby. I'm so sorry. I love to go, but I just can't do it. I got too much work ahead for tonight.
Gee, I'd like to, Bobby. But I guess no. I can't. That's all there is to it.
Okay. If that's the way you feel, guess I'll take the mud instead. Well,
So long, students. Don't strain your eyes.
Don't strain your eyes. What I like that guy means. Honestly, if I weren't graduating in June, I'd quit school right now.
Hi, it's getting late. I wish Rue didn't have so much overtime work to do. This is the second night this week she missed her supper. It's too much for young girl.
You shouldn't complain, Mom. Jobs are scarce these days. She wouldn't be secretary to the boss unless I had put in a good word for her.
Modesty isn't your virtue, Mom. I know you got me my job too. I'm properly grateful.
Well, you never think so the way you act. With all your education, you're like me. A mechanic. What good did high school do to you? I was the one who had to get you the job.
What's Ruth staying for tonight, Bobby?
Tonight is the night. I have the sneaky feeling that your story is going to wake up tomorrow morning, foreman of the department. That's why she's late. And she had to stay for the meeting. They're picking up somebody for, you know, a job right now.
Make sure she will get it.
I can't miss. I've been there over 3 years, and they always come to me with any tricky work to do. Besides, since Johnson's been sick, I really been the foreman anyway.
Man, you never get that. I just don't want to see you disappointed.
Say, you don't think you're going to get it, do you?
No, I don't. But after all, Bobby, being foreman means more than just knowing mechanics. There are reports to write out, time schedules to plan, and how in the world are you going to lay out that?
I can catch on to all. That easy enough. I'm no dumb, though.
Sure, sure. You're going to catch on, do it when everyone else had studied day after day.
Oh, Bobby.
Well, what's the matter? Did they get it? Did they pick me?
No, they didn't.
They didn't. Well, I think that's positive no, Bobby. You deserve it.
Who did get it, Ruth?
Well, come on, Ruth. Aren't you gonna tell us?
They picked Larry.
Larry?
Me? Can you imagine that?
What happened, Ruth? What did they say? Tell me.
Bobby, I'm sorry. Honestly, I am. I know how much it means to you. Everyone wanted you, Jones and Sir Terry. But they said that... They said...
What?
That you were the best mechanic they had, but... You didn't have enough education for performance now.
So that's it.
Well, well, don't take it so hard, Bobby. Your chance will come again. Come, Ruth, and get your supper warm.
No, I can't, Mother. I have to go right back. You want Larry too. You have to go right along.
Be right with you.
Well, son, it's a pretty tough break. I can't tell you how sorry I am. You see, we were 3 years ago, weren't we?
Yes, Dad. I guess you were at that. I know it all along, especially this last year. I tried to study by myself when I could. But it was no good. Well, I'm not lit yet.
Why? What do you mean, son?
Well, there's always evening school. Lots of the fellows are going, and I guess it's time for me to start.
From your sleep, the drying of your tears. Today we escape, we escape.